Good, MP.
What up, kid?
What's going on, man? Yo, I appreciate you being here, but like I said, you ain't gotta do this.
What? This is the in-person treatment that you hired me for. Look, just remember this day when Barry and Associates shows up, trying to see if you need a new agent, all right? All
right, yo, fair enough, man. So where do we start, man? Let's go on this little tour.
Well, are you ready, Sire?
Don't do that. Cut the little butler act, man. Act normal, bro.
Yeah, that didn't even feel right.
It was incredible.
All right, but check it out. First up, we have the only runway in the world that can compete with Paris Fashion Week.
Yeah, bro, that looks like a pretty normal hallway to
me. Yeah, to the untrained eye, it's a normal hallway. But we both know that them pregame walks have made fashion icons out of Russell Westbrook, SGA, LeBron James. I mean, the branding possibilities are endless, man.
All right, I see you.
Now, look, once you get some shine on the court, you know, getting your fashion bag, photographers gonna be all over you, bro. And the best part is, all you gotta do is show up ready to work, look and fly.
Come on, and I can do that, can't I?
Yeah, maybe with a little bit of help you can. Sure,
bro, I get fly to you.
It don't even matter. Right now, I just want you to focus on your game, right? Fashion can come later. All right, so check this out.
Talk to me.
Down this way, you got the press room. Now, anytime you got some post-game media availability, mm-hmm. This where you're gonna wanna go.
Okay.
Now, Ashley will meet you tonight after the game to walk you over, you know, give you some more pointers, but mm-hmm. Typically it's gonna be on you to make sure you don't miss these opportunities.
Sure.
I mean, opening yourself up more for the press, it's just better for you. I mean, but you're a natural born leader, you get that.
Bro, I do this, man. I could do media in my sleep.
All right,
you know this.
Well, one more note on that. The media is allowed all through this hallway. So you might get stopped for press time just when you're walking around. And because I said that, you are under the microscope here, all right?
Bro, you ain't gotta
act accordingly. That's all I'm saying.
You ain't gotta make it sound so intense, man. I got this.
All right.
What else you got for me?
All right, well, down here is also the arena manager's office. You mm-hmm. probably not gonna go there much, but you know, just so you know. And also, there's your standard, generic meeting room. Now, once again, you're probably not going to use it much, but, I mean, could come in handy if you need to have a private conversation.
Right. Away from the prying eyes of the tabloids, right?
Yes! Look at you paying attention! I like that!
A little bit, man.
And then down further a little bit this way, you've got the locker room. And okay. Looks like Coach Graves is waiting for you, actually.
Okay. Anything else?
That's it. Now, I got to shake some hands before tonight's game, but you go out there and have fun, man.
I mean, appreciate it, man. Again, man, it's always good seeing a familiar face in new settings.
Man, don't even mention it. That's what I'm here for. Have a great game, man.
All right, man.
You're here nice and early. Love to see it.
Just doing my job, coach.
Humble and hardworking. Those qualities like to see in a draft pick. But you already knew that. Let me show you the locker room.
Let's do it.
So obviously you've seen one of these before. Nothing too unusual. Your locker's over there.
The one with my name on it, right?
Quick study. We put the starter's name on the whiteboard over here before every game. Coach likes to keep things regular, but obviously injuries happen. People perform or they don't, so it'll change from time to time.
All right, well, hopefully it changes sooner rather than later.
Keep doing the right things, you'll be there sooner than you think.
Hey, that's the plan.
All right, hey, come on, let me show you my office. Come on in. Now, I know you're anxious to find out how you're gonna fit into the rotation.
Coach, man, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't hyped, man. You got no idea.
Like I said, we wanted to see how you performed under pressure, so we put a lot of weight in your performance in the Summer League Championship.
Oh, yeah, you were very clear about that.
Communication is super important in this organization, so I am glad to hear you say that. And I'm also glad to let you know that you'll be our sixth man to start the season.
Sixth man? Okay, can't be mad at that.
I thought you'd be a little higher in the joy scale than can't be mad at that.
Joy scale? Coach, you a life coach on the side? Getting a little pocket money there?
Yeah, I joke when I'm upset too.
I'm not upset, it's just I haven't come off the bench since my freshman year of college. And before that, never really.
I get that. But sixth man at this level is a big responsibility. People have long careers in that role and you haven't even played a game yet.
I feel you, man. It's just I have high expectations for myself and I'm not exactly at a 10 on the joy scale just yet.
I get it. 100%. Honestly, I'd be concerned if you didn't feel that way. You want to make it here, you got to have a hunger to be the best.
I mean, if you're not competing to be the best here, what are we doing?
Exactly.
What are we doing?
Exactly. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. If you want to get dressed, you know where your locker is, and once you're ready to head to the court, it's a tunnel across from the locker room. Any questions?
Ah, Koshi, I'm ready. Let's get it.
See you out there.
Grant, everyone is excited for this season opening contest. That includes the fans, but even more so the players. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in. Parker, no good. Here's Philadelphia. They're on a 17-7 run. Melton passes to Harden. And no good. Some solid defense from Williams. Boston trailing. A minute 37 left in the first. Oh, stolen by Harris. Here we go, the Sixers on the break. Oh, and there's a one-hand jam.
Adding insult to injury with the dunk off the steal.
Nice to see a good play on D. That led to some fireworks.
Let's see if that serves as a momentum builder. What a great sequence for this group.
That shot's good by Parker.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
But I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
Harden gets it to go from 8 feet. Harden's got 10.
Already 6 of their points coming off second chances. Pretty impressive.
And here's MP from outside, and it's Philadelphia with the rebound. 46 seconds left to play in the first. Here's Melton, and he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
They're not wasting any time putting their stamp on this game. What a start.
And they've been doing it largely at the offensive end. If the defense does not adjust, this could be a blowout.
Good passing to set that up. Teamwork on display.
Melton passes to Harris. And Pritchard pulls it down.
Well, that's a blown defensive coverage, but it doesn't matter. He cannot answer the bell.
That shot's good by Parker.
This night already has the makings of an offensive war.
Well, the fans love it. Coaches may not like the lack of defense, but boy, the rules promote scoring, no doubt.
And here's Harden. From deep. Oh, it goes! He got it off in time! And about 3 minutes played now in the second quarter. Oh, MP with a block. We've got Danilo Gallinari. MP is out there with Marcus Smart. Then there's Jason Tatum, and it's Williams.
Thanks, Rep. Thanks, MP. Both doing a great job.
That's his first personal foul. Third team foul.
Free throw good, MP.
Boy, when you think about the Boston Celtics and their fans, I think one thing that makes them unique, it isn't just the state of Massachusetts, right? It's the entire region of New England.
Harden, the pass to Harris. Embiid, a screen on Tatum. Harris with it, guarded now by Williams. Back to Harris. Clock at 4. To halt the run. The rebound by Jason Tatum. Yeah, Doris, if you're anywhere in the northeast portion of the U.S., you're going to see a lot of Boston jerseys.
Well, Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, Rhode Island, they all adopt the Celtics as their hometown team. But here's what's even more impressive, BA. Go to any NBA city, any of the other 29 cities, and you are going to see Celtic green jerseys. That is a fan base that travels well.
They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Harden, the pass to Harris. .102 left in the second period. From 12 feet. Rebound Boston.
Yeah, they just can't seem to end the drought no matter where they shoot it from.
And I think you can start to feel their frustration mounting. With every missed bucket, it becomes more and more desperate.
Woo! Defensively, you can't afford to let them get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
I'll tell you, you can't get stops if you're unwilling to put in the work.
Harden finds Melton. Out to Harris. Three-pointer. Well, he's now 2 for 7 after that bucket.
Always ready to fire. Give Harris a good pass. Tobias will get you an assist.
Outside Tatum. Over Embiid. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Tatum.
You're getting in their heads. Keep up the defense.
And we've got 28 seconds left to play in the second quarter. Pass to Embiid. Now Harris. And here's Embiid. Over Williams. Embiid can't hit. Parker with it to the inside. The shot. That's good from Gallinari. On the assist by Embiid.
Confidence and composure in the paint. Danilo Gallinari from inside.
And so we wrap up the first half. Celtics out in front, leading by 10. And we'll be back right after this.
43.
And as we welcome you to the studio, we call your attention to the top performers for each team in the first half.
Well, you look at these two, carrying the scoring load, both playing some fantastic basketball in the first half.
We'll see if the imminent halftime coaching adjustments can slow down either guy. Now let's talk about our game tonight, a nightmare of a first half for the Philadelphia 76ers.
They wouldn't be in such a deep hole if they hadn't given up so many offensive rebounds. Getting out hustle, getting moved around, losing possessions. The one thing you can control is effort.
And that's it for halftime. Thank you for joining us. We send you back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
We've got third quarter basketball here. Two quarters in the books. Jaylen Brown having a dominant impact in this game.
He's been a real difference maker today in terms of reeling in offensive boards.
And the 76ers, looking at who they've got. P.J. Tucker is out there with Montrezl Harrell. Then there's Tyrese Maxey. And then it's Goran Dragic. And it's Melton in at the three, a small forward.
Here in the second half, they're really focused on stretching the floor.
And guys, boy, when you're hitting, it sure does work. It obviously opens up major options at the offensive end.
Harrell the screen. Maxey against Williams. And it's Maxey missing.
You have to credit their effort. I mean, they've done an amazing job on the glass.
Here's Williams. Another one falls for Boston.
And they're really rolling right now. That lead keeps getting bigger and bigger.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
Gives us a chance to catch up with Ali LaForce.
Thanks, B.A. Well, Joel Embiid drawing comparisons to some legend.
How the heck is that a foul, ref? You need LASIK.
The line for the 76ers, Goran Dragic. At the line for two.
Joel Embiid.
Oh, no question. He's the face of this franchise. Embiid is as good as anyone in the league. Off the floor, Joel is willing to take the blame when things don't go right. That's who you want as a leader.
From deep, Embiid. That one falls. 8 of 10 and scoring with confidence.
Lackluster defense, showing no desire to chase shooters off that line.
Pass to Harrell. Going inside, and he lays it up and in. Harrell's got his first 2 points of the night.
Montrezl Harrell has great mobility and tenacity off the dribble drive. Okay, Trez.
Parker passes to Gallinari. Now Parker. Melton covers. Gets it to go. He's now 9 for 11 on the night.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
Here's Harrell. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got his fourth rebound in this one.
And right now, they're +8 in the rebounding category. That's helping them run away with this.
I tell you, he's making everything he looks at tonight. He should be their number one option on every possession.
Dragic passes to Melton. Takes a three. Ooh, he released it in time, but it's off the mark. And as substitutions are where some fans change the channel. Doris, has the league done enough to discourage intentional fouls?
Every form of media, to me, BA, is trying to capture the imagination of their fans. So anything that enhances your product is something that, in the long term, is going to do well for you.
There's the triple. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. We've got Derek White. Robert Williams out there with Justin Jackson. Then it's MP, and it's Tatum in at the three. That's the Boston Five.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Pass to Harris. Now Embiid. Harris down low, defended by Jackson. Oh, and Jackson with the defensive effort. From deep, MP. And the Celtics, another three.
When you let a team knock down that many threes, you know you're likely to be on the wrong side of a run.
Here's Melton. Oh, it's blocked by Jackson. They get it back. Boston on offense. They're on a 12-3 run. Melton against Parker. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Parker's got 18 points now here in the second half. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Celtics.
I mean, those swats. They can get into your head, make you think twice about shooting it. So it's about more than just those block numbers.
The other thing that jumps out about their performance tonight, the amount of steals really pressuring those ball handlers.
We all know rebounding is about effort. Embiid is showing lots of it. I love how he's unwilling to give up on the play. And this is how he shines. He's a big part of their floor space.
And right now, Greg, he is doing a great job delivering for this team, productive and efficient. Boy, 9 times out of 10, that's going in. I'm sure he surprised himself with the miss.
Parker outside. Off the mark there with a three. Philadelphia has gone 0-for-2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. From deep, Melton. It's good. Off the assist from Harden. 3 points. Harden's got his third assist of the night.
Well, the scoreboard tells you everything you need to know about this one. A great showing here for the Celtics.
And the disparity in the talent was obvious by the end. Sometimes you just don't have enough ammunition to compete.
Yeah, BA, just a total beatdown. And the next time these teams meet, I can't imagine it'll be any different.
And so this win marks their first victory of the new year.
It's just the start of this season series with 3 games left between them, but it must feel great to take the first meeting.
And one player just stole the show tonight, doing everything for his team. A monster night for MP.
No doubt he came to play tonight. This guy has been aggressive and effective.
Harden, the pass to Thybul. To the right side. Here's Embiid. He can't get that one to fall. Some solid defense from Williams. White finds Parker. Jackson with it. The kick out to White. Hey, expanding his range. And MP with a basket on the assist by White. Parker's got 42 in the game.
Stepping up and nailing an important shot to put this away.
Yeah, playing with great energy and great effort. And as a coach, you'd love to see this from your team every single night.
Here's Embiid. Over Williams. And too long on the shot. Now White. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. They didn't have too many problems tonight.
They didn't. Just a tremendous team effort. Once they had that big lead, they were not going to let the visitors back into the game.
And that'll do it for this inaugural game of the NBA season. For Ali LaForce, Grant Hill, and Doris Burke, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching tonight's game. We'll see you next time.
Hey, MP, you're needed in the press room.
Can I get a... Hey, MP, how was the game? You look really good out there. How are you feeling out there?
Hey, how are you feeling? Also, you're needed in the press room.
Okay, so we could just skip the small talk then.
Yeah, follow me. I'm gonna give you a rundown of the situation. We don't have much time, so I need you to listen closely because I will not be repeating myself.
Okay, I'm all ears.
Obviously, they're gonna wanna ask questions about how you played, so if you feel like you underperformed at all, you're gonna wanna call on John Luck. If you feel like you underperformed at all, you're gonna wanna call on John Luck because his whole thing is access, so he's bound to lob you a softball or two. Feeling confident, you're gonna wanna call on Nate White, the man fans love to hate. His number one goal is to stir up controversies, so if you messed up even a little bit, he's gonna be all over that. Also, he's going to have a couple Shep questions to throw your way, so if you want to get into that, then he's your guy. The other major player on the beat is Candace Green. She's not here today, but she likes to get into the longer view of things, really get into the X's and O's. So if you want to brag about your basketball IQ, she is your person to call on.
Okay. All right. Hey, is there someone that you would choose first if you were me? Is there a conversation I should stay away from, you know?
That is completely up to you.
Yeah.
What you say in that room is going to go a long way in establishing your identity as a leader and your personal brand.
Okay.
And though I might have ideas about what you should say in a given situation, I can't tell you who to be.
Yeah.
Now, that doesn't mean you should go starting any giant PR nightmares,
No.
But there is more than one way to skin the proverbial cat, if you follow me.
Yeah, for sure. Any more advice you got?
Lots, but you're needed inside. Go.
Yeah. We're here.
We are indeed. All right, look, I just gave you a lot of information in a short amount of time. And what I want you to know is that what drew me to you as a potential employer was your grace under pressure. I've just always really respected the way that you handle yourself in the press, and I think you're gonna do a fantastic job in there.
Wow, you really fought through that one. But thank you. It's probably one of the nicest things you said to me. All right.
You really need to get in there. They get cranky if they think they're gonna miss deadlines.
I got you, I'm in there.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, everyone. All right, man, you up first right here.
Congrats on your first NBA win, MP.
Thanks, Nate.
So, what would you say you struggled with the most out there? I mean, after your first NBA action, is there a specific part of your game you know you need to work on?
You know, Nate, man, you are a real ray of sunshine. You know that?
I try. So, you don't have anything to work on?
Whoa. I'm not gonna let you twist my words around like that. So, of course, I've got things that I need to work on. Who doesn't? You know, I just think it's funny that you lead off with such a negative question. You know, you could have asked me anything. What are you comfortable with? You know what I'm saying?
Well,
but you choose to start negatively?
Well, I don't think that's very interesting.
I bet you don't.
Well, so is that a no comment?
Nah, I got you, man. I got you. For me right now, the hardest part is just gelling with my teammates. My game, which I'm always confident in, but this is a team sport, you know, so I got to figure out how to fit my game into what the team needs me to do. You know, obviously we got the dub tonight, so that's a huge plus, so I'm not worried about it. But, you know, that's probably what needs to be worked on long term, just gelling it all together. Okay, next question. John.
There were a lot of media outlets in the preseason that made a big deal about the fan base's so-called negative reaction to you on draft day, but I did see quite a few people in the stands supporting you. Mm-hmm. Could you speak a little bit about that?
Yeah, John, you know, I felt that support tonight, and it was love. You know, I can't complain about that. But I think with the whole, you know, Shep controversy was a bit of a, like, a media creation, you know, if we're being honest here. Now, don't get me wrong, you know, it's not like I feel like I should be handed the keys to the city or, you know, get the red carpet rolled out for me. But these days, it feels like everyone has an opinion, you know, so you can always find someone that's willing to put you down if you look for it. You know, it's there. You know, for me, I'm just more focused on the people that support me. Genuinely, you know, and I've got plenty of support in the city, so it feels good.
The times we live in, right? Thanks, MP.
Yeah, no problem, man. Good question, by the way. No more questions? Cool. Yeah, take it easy.
Great game.